Hey everyone, welcome to the semicolon. In this video, we'll be learning about a very popular method for representing text called Word2Vec. So machine learning and deep learning algorithms cannot accept text directly. We need some sort of numerical representation so that the algorithms can process the data. And in simple machine learning applications, we use contractorizer or TF-IDF, both of which do not preserve any relationship between the words. This is where word embeddings come in. They map all the words in a language into a vector space of a given dimension. So Word2Vec is a popular method to generate word embeddings. This converts words into vectors, and with vectors, we have multiple operations like add, subtract, calculate distance, and that is how relationship among the words are preserved. So one example of this relationship is a very famous result of Word2Vec, which says the vector of the word king minus word man plus the word woman gives you the word vector of the word queen. And this relationship is preserved by Word2Vec just by iterating through a large corpus of text like a Wikipedia or a newspaper corpus. So Word2Vec is generally included in a lot of deep learning courses. But there's no deep learning involved in generating word embeddings using Word2Vec. It is just a simple two-layered neural network. Now that being said, a lot of deep learning applications involving text have shown improvement after using Word2Vec embeddings as features. Training the Word2Vec model is also very resource intensive as it requires large amount of RAM to store the vocabulary of the corpus. So now the question is, how are these relationships formed? In simple terms, Word2Vec tries to make the words with similar contexts have similar embeddings. So let's consider an example to understand it better. So we have two sentences. The kid said he would grow up to be Superman, and the child said he would grow up to be Superman. If you observe the words kid and child, they are two different words with same contexts. And since Word2Vec tries to make words with similar contexts have similar embeddings, kid and child will have similar vectors. When you iterate through a large corpus, you would get a lot of sentences where kid is replaceable by child, and hence these vectors will have similar embeddings. And how does Word2Vec do the task of generating vectors from the words? So there are two algorithms for it: continuous bag of words, CBOW, and Skipgram. In continuous bag of words, or CBOW, we predict the target word from the context, something like this. And in Skipgram, we try to predict the context words from the target word. You may ask, why are we trying to predict words when we need vectors for each word? I'll answer the question later on in the video. For now, let's look at the detailed working of each of this method. So for that, we'll need a smaller example, because English language has around 13 million words in the dictionary, which is quite huge for an example. So let's consider a language which has just 5 words. So those words are can, free, hope, set, and you, and nothing else. So we initially encode each word as one hot vector. And to generate word vectors from this vocabulary, we iterate through a corpus. And for simplicity, let's assume our corpus has just one sentence. That is, hope can set you free. So now we need to select a window size for iterating over the sentences. So let's consider it to be 3 in this case. And as discussed earlier, in continuous bag of words, we try to predict the center word from the context words. So our window size is 3. The center word is the word we need to predict using the 2 words surrounding it. So we use a simple neural network for this. And when the neural network has the context words hope and set as input, we need our neural network to predict can. There is one more thing which we need to choose, that is the size of each vector. Let's say the size of each vector is 3. Then we'll choose the hidden layer to be of size 3. So our neural network now looks something like this. One important thing to note here is the 5x3 input matrix is shared by the context words, and we pass the one hot vector of hope and set, and our neural network tries to predict the center word. We pass it through the softmax function, get the probabilities, and compare it with the actual word. And then the error is used to update the weights. Then we slide the window and continue the same process. This way, the weights are updated. And once done, we take the weight matrix of these weights, and these are the set of our vectors. And this is how continuous bag of words work. The case of Skipgram is very similar. In Skipgram, we choose the window size and give the center word as input, trying to predict the context words. The weights are updated in a similar way. And here again, the output matrix of size 5x3 is shared by the context words. This way, both the algorithm help updating the weight matrix based on the words and context. Then we generally take the input weight matrix and multiply it with the one hot vector of a particular word to obtain its word vector. Now this word vector is what we call word embeddings. In real applications, we generally train it over Wikipedia text, choosing window size around 5 to 10 and vector size is generally around 300. The number of words in the corpus is around 13 million. And hence it takes huge amount of resource to train and generate word embeddings. If you want to skip this process, you may very well go ahead and download the pre-trained word vectors. You can choose any one of the two algorithms, Skipgram or continuous bag of words. In general, continuous bag of words is preferred for smaller corpus and is faster to train. Skipgram is slower but works well on large corpus and large dimensions. There are few other things to tweak to improve accuracy, like adding more data, and this is kind of obvious. We can also increase the dimensions of word vector, and in this way, more information will be preserved. Increasing the window size also helps, but it makes training a little difficult. So this is all about Word2Vec and word embeddings. In the next video, we'll look at how we can implement this in Python. Thank you.